So there is a major problem with a lot of Rocket League tutorials, mine included, and it's that the tips and guides are from the experience of those creating them. Whilst most of them are still amazing and provide some great advice for both new and old players alike, they miss one key aspect. You guys. I've seen plenty of comments on both my own and other YouTubers' videos saying that they would love to see a guide on how to improve on X skill or Y mechanic, as well as a lot of low rank players telling them to just get good because they can do double resets in gold. Yeah, sure you can, mate. Anyway, so that is what I've done. I asked all of you, my YouTube and Discord community, for your top 3 areas for improvement in Rocket League, and then I've made a tutorial covering your top 5 responses. For those of you who didn't see, I released a survey for everyone to answer, and received over 1,000 responses, so thank you to all of you who took the time out of your day to help me out. Just quickly before we continue, we recently reached 25,000 subscribers and are halfway to our goal of 50,000 by the end of the year. So if you haven't already, please consider subscribing, it would be a great way to support the channel and it would mean a lot. So without further ado, let's dive into the results. Rotation and positioning was the biggest area for improvement as selected by you guys, with 48.4% of you selecting it as one of your 3 choices. This was closely followed by ball control, which includes dribbling and flicks, on 43.1%, and further back was mentality, game speed and aerials on 34.7%, 32.5% and 32% respectively. Unfortunately, shooting was beaten out by 0.7%, so I won't cover it, but I can definitely recommend Thanavik's and Waiten's tutorials for this, so go check those out if you're interested. Despite the other 4 responses being chosen less, they are still really important, so don't ignore them even though I won't provide a tutorial on them. Also, to the 5 of you who chose every response, like, why? Just why? So, now that I've gathered what are the top areas for tutorials and tips that you guys want to see, I'm going to spend the next few minutes going over each of them. So, if one or more of your areas was in the top 5, then be sure to stick around. As rotation and positioning was the most selected area, I won't make you guys wait until the end, I'll talk about it straight away. Firstly, this is an extremely broad topic to discuss and explain, especially in a few minutes, so I'll try to sum up some basic rules and tips. Unlike mechanics, there is less teaching involved, rather observation from your behalf and then learning from that. A golden rule of rotation and positioning is to be constantly aware of your teammates' position as much as your opponent's, and to be aware when they are going to or actually are going for the same ball as you. Double commits are to rotation like flip resets are to platinums, they are its kryptonite, so try to avoid them at all costs. As a way of implementing this, a good idea is to utilise something called the 45 degree method. This means that you position yourself behind your teammate on a 45 degree angle, increasing your field coverage as well as allowing you to collect a missed challenge or to go if the ball goes forward. Additionally, a simple yet effective way to improve rotation almost instantly is to start rotating far or back post. In a nutshell, this means that when you are going back to goals, you move towards the post that is further from the play, as it allows you to maintain momentum as the ball can only be shot in front of your car, compared to if you're stuck in net and really awkward, yeah, it's just not ideal. You can also watch some higher level gameplay to get an idea of what more sophisticated rotation looks like, which will benefit you more than almost any other area as it is so focused on observation. The second largest area for improvement from the community was ball control, which are classified as including dribbling and flicks. Ball control is extremely useful in every rank and allows you to maintain possession and score from awkward positions. In order to dribble, you firstly want to hop into free play and practice cutting the ball and hitting it around whilst keeping it close to your car. Also, make sure you use car or free cam, as ball cam can make this a lot harder. Once you've mastered this, you can practice rolling the ball along the sideboard to get a feel for how to control your speed whilst dribbling the ball on your roof. Once you can do that, you can practice dribbling it on your roof. A really important point is that you shouldn't really be using boost at all. This is because it gives you a sudden and large change in speed, causing the ball to jolt around on your roof like this. Simply using the accelerator and maintaining a good constant speed is enough. Again, use car cam and with enough repetition and practice, you should be able to keep it on your roof for a period of time. Moreover, when flicking the ball, the key thing to understand here is where the ball is positioned on your roof. If it is too far forward or back, your flicks won't work. It must be in a position similar to on-screen now, where when you flip forward, the back of your car can hit the ball without it falling off the front or back. You should only try to attempt this if you can easily dribble the ball on your roof, as it requires a lot more mechanical skill and muscle memory. To practice any of this, either use free play or a training pack called Dribble Flick Playground with this code. They are both great ways to improve your ball control and flicks. Moving on to area number 3, which was mentality. This is an extremely important aspect of Rocket League, so I'm glad so many of you acknowledged it. There is no mechanic or objective way to get a better mentality, which is probably why a lot of you feel that you struggle with it. It's pretty easy to get tilted when your teammate own goals in OT, especially when there's nobody around, and I'm guilty of having a bad mentality from time to time. One of the main reasons why people have a bad mentality is the following. They believe that their teammates are holding them back, leading them to get angry at said teammates, resulting in more tilt and forfeits, which leads them to feel that their teammates are holding them back even more, resulting in more tilts and losses. You get the picture. It's a vicious positive feedback loop that can easily spiral out of control. And as much as you may hate to hear it, your teammates are your rank because they possess the same overall skill as you. No, they may not be able to air dribble or pull off good saves like you can, but then you will lack in an area that they excel in. What separates a good solo queue player from a bad one is the ability to identify your teammates' weak areas and to make up for them. If they are ball chasing or playing over aggressively, just play more defensive to compensate. So, instead of getting tilted because your teammate doesn't play the way you want them to, play the way you need to in order to win. Rocket League is a team game, so you must treat it like one. Teams succeed off the back of selfless efforts, not selfish ones. Additionally, players often focus so heavily on rank that they forget about skill level. They are so fixated on getting diamond or champion that they forget to train and focus on their weak areas, instead playing hundreds of rank games and expecting improvement. You must prioritize skill over rank, as ranking up is a result of an increase in skill, but skill is not a result of an increase in rank. Lastly, improvement doesn't happen overnight. It can take hundreds of hours to get into champ, and even more to get into grand champ. Try to look at things holistically. Do a few losses really matter out of several thousand games? No. If you're good enough to rank up, you will win more than you lose in the long run, and you will improve. So after that lengthy discussion about mentality, we have game speed at number 4. This is something that is kind of tough to explain, hence why so many of you probably struggle with it. It's pretty easy to know that you need to play faster, but how do you do this without your mechanics crumbling or it turning into ball chasing? The best thing I can recommend is free play. Tons and tons of free play. Just put in some music and sit in free play for an hour or more, hitting the ball around and experimenting with what you can do. Push your limits as there is no consequences. It's better to whiff a ball in free play than in game, which is why it's so important. Test your reads and just instantly jump for everything, regardless of whether you think you can hit it or not. After a while, you actually will be able to, and you'll be faster than people in your rank. In terms of the ball chasing problem, the best way to know if this is becoming an issue is overcommits, leaving your teammates in 1v2s or 1v3s, or conceding a lot of open nets. Playing fast doesn't mean challenging everything, it means that you are fast to decide and execute. If you challenge, you do it fast, and if you go back, you go straight to the correct position or for boost. Try to remove all the idle decision time where you aimlessly drive around. Be decisive, responsive, and quick, not brainlessly challenging. And lastly, we have aerials, which comes under two brackets, speed and precision. To execute a good aerial, you need both, as they go together like
peas and carrots.
Firstly, to improve the speed of your aerial, you must learn something called a fast aerial, which allows you to double jump whilst boosting. In essence, it involves you jumping whilst pulling back the stick, letting go and jumping again, then continuing to boost the entire time. Like I've shown you before, it can get you to the ceiling much faster than any other form of aerial, so it's a must have in your mechanic arsenal. Now for precision. Simple aerial drills like flying around the field whilst air rolling and from goal to goal backwards will help you get the muscle memory down really fast. Once you've done this enough, training packs such as Devo are a great way to practice hitting a fast moving ball on target. There are so many packs to practice aerials, so just go through the browse page until you find one that takes your fancy. So, hopefully I was able to provide some tips on what you guys actually need to improve and work upon, and that they actually do help you out, as this was the aim of the video, a tutorial founded by you guys and created by me. Anyway, so if you enjoyed it, please consider liking and subscribing, it's a great way to engage with and support the channel. Other than that, have a great day. Cheers.